Hi, today I'm going to be showing you how to initialize the ArcMIS information, hospital information system. The idea is that the technology guy has set up the system and you can log in as an admin person. And so the question is, what next do you have to do to get the system to work? Okay, so we're going to be talking about the user management model, which is the foundational model for the health information system or the hospital information system, because that's key. That's where all the resources are replicated electronically so that they can become useful for you in the application and reflect what is actually going on out in the real world. All right, so you could log in and come in the admin. Which admin password? Great, so once you're in, you would hit the dashboard, and we're gonna be focused on this button and menu item here, setup. Please ignore all the remaining items, we just focused on setup. That is where user management is embedded. So that's the module, the user management module, and that's the icon that leads. So if I click on that, it gives me a list of many options that I'm going to drill down to. Before I go into this, I need to explain how all this is organized and give you an insight to what this menu do. So, like I said, we're doing the ArcMIS installation. We're talking about the user management. Basically, the user management is organized in about five components. So you have the human resources, you have the physical resources, you have associations, you have roles, and then you have roster. Great. And so for human resources, this deals with how the various employees, you know, basically human beings are represented in the system, and they're organized as departments and into departments and units. So units make up a department and the department makes up part of the hospital. So every employee must belong to a department and must belong to a unit subsequently. Physical resources talks about locations in the hospitals, you know, across board. So you'd have the location, you have the location types, which basically two of them, you either have clinical locations or non-clinical locations. All right, and within this, you'd have your major location, right? The major locations are the key clinical areas, environments within the hospital. So this would be like your theater, your ward, the theater, the ward, the clinics, and other, you know, environments that you would have to engage with a patient in. Then you have the minor locations, which are your named major locations. So if you have like an outpatient clinic, which is called surgery outpatient, so that would be a minor location. Now this is the location. I don't want you to miss it with the service that actually happens in those locations. These are locations, these are like physical buildings that you can go to, or you know, people going to work in. So the next thing to talk about is the roles. And these roles basically reflect what an employee can do within the applications. And you'd have software administrators, you have job roles, and then you have basic roles, which are all folded one into the other. The software administrator basically determines at a global level, you know, access to settings, right? While the job roles are what the various employee can actually do within a particular model or cannot do. And the basic roles gives you a read-write functionality for that role. So that role is you can have a role that enables you to read, but at the same time you cannot write and you cannot delete from it. Across board, you know, generally when you have a create, read, update, delete, it's called CRUD, just as a short form. Next is associations. In association, we're linking one resource to the other resource, or one role, you know, to a resource. So basically, it's how you coordinate between the human resources, the physical resources, and the roles, and how they interplay in that. So you could have where you're locating, associating a unit to a location, which is okay. That is where the unit works, or you're putting an employee in a unit, as well as giving roles to the employee. In most instances, when it comes to location and unit integration or association, most units would work in one location. So a nurses would go to work in a ward and we remain in that ward. A nurse could go to clinic and remain in that clinic. But there's a difference for doctors, because they tend to be everywhere across board. So they tend to have like a one doctor can go to clinic in the morning and then be in the ward in the afternoon, or be in the clinic 1 minute and then the next clinic is on the ward, the other minute is in theater. So he's kind of more scattered around like that, and we tend to handle them differently. Roster brings in the time frame aspect for the employee. So he talks about how long or what duration the employee can engage in a particular setting. At a particular time. So if an employee is on leave and he comes in and signs on the application, because he's been placed on leave within the roster, he will not be able to do anything. The good thing about APMIS is that it's not just role-based, it's also roster-based. So if someone is on leave, he's out of system. Someone's supposed to be close from work, he's close from work, he cannot get access into the system again, except we'll set him up. So you have that granular control over things and how employees engage with the application. And so for that to happen, you need to have a user. Now, a user is an employee or a staff of the hospital who has been given a username and password. It's not every employee that would have a username and password, I mean, for instance. And so it's critical that we understand that and don't make that mistake. So you have to have a user, you have to have a unit, you have to have locations, and then you then create a shift, which is the time frame for a particular named work instance. So, and that work instance could be either, the fact that that person is required to be in the hospital, or it could be an instance that doesn't require the person to be in the hospital. So the leave doesn't require to be for the person to be in the hospital. Off doesn't require the person to be in the hospital. You know, where morning shift, afternoon shift, or an all-day shift will require the person to be in the hospital. Now, shift is done at the departmental level. So once you create that, the department decides. This department most likely will be unique in how they operate their time frames. And so we're giving them that control to be able to do that at that level. Great. So just a brief overview again. User management is organized in five components. You have human resources, you have physical resources, you have roles, you have associations, and then you have roster. Great. Now, the menu items that you have, again, would reflect this with one addition, which is the global setup. So you have human resources, you have physical resources, you have roles, you have association, you have roster, and then you have global setup. Global setup are basically some parameters that you require to be able to use the application. The app is set in such a way that almost everything is configurable in the system. So you can change it, you can manipulate with it, even though we suggest that you do that as little as possible. But you can set up every tiny bit that is happening there. So the software allows you to have that kind of granular control. One thing at the back of our mind when we're developing APMIS is to give granular control, is to have a software that, you know, you really can go in there and change things and you know, work with it, you know, without having to call us or without having to rebuild the application again. So we'll run through this menu item. So for human resources, you have the department, you have units, you have users, you have designations. Designations talk about how you know, within a professional setting, what like the cadre of that person is, you know. So if there's a doctor, he could be a consultant, he could be a senior reg, he could be a resident, a registrar one, a registrar two, and all that. So just the destinations for that. Secondly, you have profession. So profession, basically, you know, you set up a profession, a doctor, a nurse, and all that's created. And so you then go on to create an employee, you then you can update an employee, and you can then update the department that an employee belongs to. So department, you create the department, you create the unit for a department. You can add users, which are employees, and you can assign user name and password. You create designations, you create profession, you go create an employee and all that. I'll just switch over to just show you the buttons there. Great. Okay, so we're talking about so you have update employees and department, so you can do that. Update employees, there, create employees, that's the profession. You add up a new profession, you create a designation, and you attach that to a profession. And then you go to create department. Great, department and unit. So those are the things that you can do, basic setup parameters for that to happen. So let's talk about physical resources. Physical resources, like I said, physical locations within the hospital. So you have location type, and you have major locations and minor locations. Like I pointed out, minor locations are named major locations. So let's go back to the software and just look at those three menu items. So you have location type. Again, this has already been done. You may likely never need to do that. So you have non-clinical and clinical. Then you go to major locations, which are your pharmacy, your clinic, your laboratory, your ward, you know, radiology, you know, records and all that. Like I said, when you're creating it, you need to have to name it, whether it's a non-clinical or it's a clinical environment, all right? And then for your minor location, you're naming, you have a named instance, you know, for that major location. So you could have pharmacy, and you could have stuff like a central pharmacy store. You could have clinic, and you'd have O&G clinic, hematology clinic, nephrology clinic. I mean, depending on whatever name, you know, you have named it, and that is a named instance for you, is for that physical structure. And then you'd have workspace environment, really, not necessarily physical structure, but workspace and environment for that person to deal with. Great. So those are the three key things you do for the physical for physical resources. Roles, again, like I said, you have basic roles, you have job roles, you have basic role, and you know, association with the job role with the basic role. Job roles are basically what the person can do within that application, and we'll be looking at an example of that. You have employee, crude, which is where you basically, this I think should fall more in line with association, because it's where you associate an employee to his job role. Okay, and then you have software, the software administrator, which I've talked about, which is high level control, able to have access to settings within the application. If you're not a software administrator, irrespective of the level, you will never see that setup button at all. So if you've not been assigned that role, you won't do that. And then where you create modules, and then where you swap departments, basically that allows the administrator to be able to do a number of stuff, even if he doesn't belong to that department. So I guess I'm just going to move this to my global setup. Okay, so there we go. So we've talked about all that. I'll just show you in the application. So you got basic roles, which are your read write, like I said. You have job roles. Again, this has to be based on the model that you have. So medical record, you have coding, registration, and statistics. Pharmacy, you have administrator, central store pharmacy, clerical store pharmacy, and satellite store pharmacy. You know, so those are job roles. Some of this, really, you never have to do anything about them, because they're basically set up within the application. And here is where you add the job role. So you pick up a module, and you create your read write and associate it with that, and basically you're done with roles. So I need to show you the software administrator. Okay, so software administrator, you basically have to choose the person and choose the kind of roles that he's associated with. Whether it's a global administrator, unit administrator, departmental administrator. Of course, that job role was created here. So if I choose setup, you see I got three types of administrator there, and that's it. So okay, so we're moving software administrator to an association, because really you're associating people there. Okay, so in association we have where we associate unit, location to unit. So that means that okay, this unit works in this workspace. Okay, and then we go on to the role to department. So that means that this department has these roles that have been assigned to it, and the people in that department can consume that role. We can assign job roles to that. So if a department doesn't have a role assigned to it, that means that it would not, if it locks on, you won't be able to get, if anybody in that department locks on, you won't be able to get access to that module. So first and foremost, we need to assign that module to the department and make it globally available to everybody in the department. And then we have units, employee unit mapping, which is where we take an employee and we put them inside a unit. And then we have employee crew, which is where we take that employee and assign it job roles that are associated with that person. And then if we look at software administrator, is where we determine an employee can have access to various setup. Okay, I think I need to put this off. Okay, great. So it doesn't stop me any longer. Okay, so that's about association. So let me go back to the application and show you the various associations that we need to make it functional. So yeah, I've got employee unit mapping. All right, and as you can see, this is more at the departmental level. So you choose the employee. When you select the employee, you choose the unit that's available, and you can assign that patient, that employee to the unit. Employee crew, we've seen that. You pick up the unit, you choose the employee, you choose the roles, and then you can assign them as well. Okay, so we'll be looking at some more details into this as we go down the line. So that's here is location to unit, where you choose the department, you choose the unit that is available under that department, so that you can set up the where the location to work. So the location is more like a workspace environment for a particular unit. So if I had medical records, just want to see, so I got registration as a unit, and I can go in there and choose my registration type in this instance, which would be non-clinical, and then I can choose records, and then I can choose various locations with it, central registration, and then go ahead and assign that. Great. So roster, like I pointed out, roster is where you set up the roster. So for roster, you have the roster setup and you have the shift setup. So and again, that's done at departmental level. So I just go ahead and show you on the menu. You scroll down to the bottom. So that's where you set up a shift, you name the shift, you determine the time and determine whether it's an off or leave shift, and then you create that. And then roster, you choose the person, and then you create the timing for the person to use that. And basically it's done. You set the date, the start date and the end date, the type of shift you want to assign to the person, and you just basically work it off from there. The unit where the person is supposed to be, the location where the person, the minor location where the person is supposed to be, and then the shift. Now all this is tied down based on, you know, all the configuration you've made before in doing that. Okay, and then global setup. Global setup is just a list of parameters that is required across, most likely in registration. So you'd have local government, sex, country, state, education level, identification type, ethnicity, denomination, registration point, whether the registration point, and where you might registration point to a minor location. Registration point basically is used for where you have multiple registration numbers within a hospital. Somewhere like you say, they have like five different locations, you know, that you can get registered in, and they'll give you different registration numbers and types. So accident and emergency will be a registration point. Oncology, registration oncology will be another registration point, and your psychiatry will be a different registration point and with different numbers. And so you need to be able to replicate that in the system, and that's why we have that. So, you know, you can add like 10 or 20, depending on what size of hospital and how they're working. You can add that to it. And your registration point, the minor location, is where you then assign those registration points to those minor locations. So you say, for this workspace, this is the kind of registration that they do, and this is the mode of registration that they do. So that allows you to be able to have that flexibility and control over how the things work. So it reflects exactly what is happening in reality, as much as is possible. Mobility, I think we use that in radiology, is a person walking, sitting, and all that, and it could be used across board. So generating a report for, registration, and then, like I said, you know, swap apartments, where you just, as an admin person, you only go to another apartment or a global admin and be able to do some stuff at that level, really. Okay, so those I'll just show you. But I think they're really pretty simple. It's creating stuff to a large extent. So local government, I think we basically have all the list of local government. So if you look at Nigeria, okay, and we, so you basically have all the states in the country. So take Ogun. So if they add a new local government area, you can come and modify it here. It'd be, if they change the local government area, you can do that. If they add a new state, you can come to the state and create it. And country, education level, education type, denominations, Christian, not Christian, you know, stuff like that. So you basically can work with that. Denomination, ethnicity. So we've got a list of all, like all the ethnicity. That's in there, and so basically that's how it works out. So most of this is just set once. You might never really need to use them, but for the sake of this video, it's worthwhile just showing you what the menu buttons do and what they are required for. Great. So we looked at the menu items. Now we come to the meat of the issue, right? How do we initialize the system? Excuse me. As you realize, there are two people that would have to do this work. One is the global administrator, and then the second is the departmental administrator. Really, everything starts with the global administrator, because he needs to set up somebody, an employee, as the departmental administrator. So you're coming into the application clean. There's no employee, there's nothing into the system apart from just the global administrator, which is a default you will get when the application is set up. Okay, so what the global administrator needs to do falls into four categories, right? He's going to set up human resources, he's going to set up physical resources, he's going to set up roles, and he's going to set up associations. So let's start with human resources, right? So he's going to create departments first and foremost. So the first thing you need to do once you come in is to create the department. The second thing you need to do is to create professions. The third thing you need to do is create designation. And then the fourth thing you need to do is create employees. And then the fifth thing you need to do is create users. And then you then choose out of those users one person that is going to be a departmental administrator. The other things that you can do is to then go ahead to the physical resource part and create minor locations. Your major locations most likely would have been set up in the system already. So you want to create named, you know, locations for the minor locations. So you want to go across every clinic, you create every clinic, you create every ward, you create every theater, you create every lab and stuff like that, and you just take it, you know, going on from there. So you create all the minor locations, and then you come into associate roles. Okay, so you're going to give a role to somebody, you know, either as a global administrator or as an employee. Any of these people that you've created, any of the employees here that you've added, you can then go and assign them a global administrator role, which would be like, you know, he would have access to top level setup, really. So for us, the global administrator is not somebody that can do anything, really. He's someone that just has access to doing setup, because for us the hospital environment is very complex, and we want whoever has the knowledge at that level to be able to handle it, you know. So some of all those things are delegated to the departmental administrator, all right, and not just the global admin. So for this software admin, you have a like global administrator, and then you have a departmental administrator. Can you see that departmental admin? Great. So that's what the global administrator can do, and then he goes on to create associations, you know, takes the units and gives them their work environment, and then he assigns roles to the department. Once he's done all this function, his job is done with the application, and the rest lies with the departmental administrator. I just want you to note that he has to assign, the global administrator has to assign a role to the department, you know, that he creates. So he needs to assign radiology department, you know, to have access to radiology module. Otherwise, if anybody logs in radiology department, they won't see it. He needs to assign registration module to, module and its roles to registration, to medical records or health records or reception, whatever that department is called. Otherwise, nobody we get access when they log in. Great. So for the departmental administrator, what he can do basically lies on the free restriction. He's in charge of roster setting. The global administrator does not set roster, except maybe for IT people. So most likely the global administrator is an IT guy in most instances. I mean, that's the way it's been built. So he said human resource actions to take, he has association actions to take, and then he has roster actions to take. So for the human resource, he needs to create the unit, okay, and then for association, he needs to put the departmental administrator would have to put employees in unit and then assign job roles to the employee, which with the employee crude menu item, and then finally he's got to set up a roster for them. So that's the balance and the interplay between the global administrator and the departmental administrator in initializing the application. Okay, so if you can see, I've also numbered those processes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 in the sequence that they should occur, and I'm going to run through that sequence when I close on this and roll out this. So this is the process for initializing the system. Okay, there are 13 steps. The ones in bold are the ones for the departmental administrator to do. So this will be done by the departmental administrator, this will be done by the departmental administrator, this will be done by the departmental administrator, and this will be done by the departmental administrator. So we'll just go back now and take it a step at a time and look at how this turn out in the application. So the first thing is to create department. Okay, so here we go, we're going to create department. So we hit on the department menu bar and we create department. So you enter the department, you click on new, you enter the department name and you click on save. Okay, so we've already set this one up, and so you have all various departments. In another video, I'm going to be showing a clean setup where you don't have anything at all, but it's nice to see what's been done. So that gives you a good view. So that's the department. So once that is done, the next thing for you to come to do is to set up profession. So we go to profession. I'm going to set up profession. So here we go, profession. So again, click on new, you enter the profession, like nurse. And you save. Great. So that profession has been added to that. So the next thing you do after you set up profession is to go set up designation. So you take a profession and you add this designation. So designation. Great. Okay, so but here we've got all that set up already. So you just click on new, you name the profession and you choose ones you want, and you can have all that set up in all this. So this is for doctors, this is for pharmacists, and then it goes on. So the next thing you want to do is to create employees. Okay, you'll find out that when we're going to be creating employees, we'll need these three parameters that were set up before to be able to create employees effectively. So let's go create employees. So click on create employees. Great. So like I was saying, you have departments you created before, profession which you created before, and then destination which you created before. So the PIN is the personal identification number for the patient, for that employee within the hospital. You just enter that there, you choose the title. Again, like I showed, you can set this up yourself. And then the surname, the first name, the middle name, the full name. Then you have sex, and then you have the grade level, you get position, you got categories, and then departments. So grade level, I mean, this is salary scale, and position is his name position within the system, within the hospital. Categories, the department, the profession. So if I choose a profession doctor, I'm going to see, you know, all that doctors have here, that's tied in already. So if I choose pharmacist, I'm going to see various levels of pharmacists here. I mean, this reflects a public service type setting, so you can understand how that's set up. I mean, for your hospital, it might be different than that. And then the day he was appointed, I mean, you can basically ignore the time and just fill in the date. You fill in the dates as required. Please always remember to click create first so that you can activate the save button and or the update button as well. On this side, if you choose accident and emergency, you're going to see all the patient or all the employees that are there already. If I choose audit, if I choose dentistry, so it gives you an idea, you know, before you register, just to be sure that it's not, otherwise you try an error saying that the patient's already is in the system. Okay, so you've created an employee. So what's the next thing to do? You go on to create a user. So you take that employee you've created and you add him as a user. I must say that you don't have to do this like for one person. You have to go through all that process. You can batch it, create all the departments, create all the professions, create all the designations for the professions, and then, you know, enter all the employees before you now go to begin to create users. So use up there. Great. So you click on new, you choose the departments, and you find the employee within the department. You enter the username and password, you confirm the password, and you save. Simple and done, and you're good to go. So that's how you create a user. So once you finish creating the user, begin to assign one person for each department as the departmental administrator. I would advise that you do this in, you know, hand in hand with the head of the department to choose who the departmental administrator will be, because the departmental administrator is the person that's going to be responsible for setting up all the departmental parameters that are required for the application to work effectively, or for them to be able to use the application well. So for you to do that, you simply come to software administrator, right? You choose the department, and then you choose a person, and then you choose the kind of you know, role you want to give to him as a departmental administrator or as a global administrator. Okay, you can actually choose also a unit administrator, but really that more or less will lie with the department administrator to elect a unit administrator and be able to do things for that unit. But I think the two major things to just dwell with now is the global administrator and then the departmental administrator. So that's fine. So once that's set up and you save, that person can then log in as a departmental administrator and do their work. Okay, so after that's been done, the next thing to do is to create a unit. Okay, so the departmental administrator would log in. Remember, everything in bold is done by the departmental administrator. So creating a unit is a role for the departmental administrator. So the departmental administrator will log in into his application and create the unit within his application. So if you go up, okay, so you can see this is tied to the login. So for the global user, he's in the information technology, you know, unit, and that's you know, fixed. You can't change this. So the departmental hospital has to go in, log in as department hospital, and create a unit for them. You can ignore the his clinic checkbox. It's us for us to know that's a clinic location. Workspace, because you have some parameters that is there. So, but again, that will be done by the nurses or the doctors and whoever needs to do that. So you don't bother yourself about that. So once the unit has been done, the ball is passed back onto the departmental, the global administrator. He needs to go and assign location to unit. Now, most of the global resources are managed by the global administrator, while the departmental resources are managed by the department administrator. So the you need to call in the global administrator to come in and go do location to unit mapping. So he looks at all the locations that have been created for that department, and then with the department administrator, you know, they work hand in hand to associate those workspace to those units. So basically now I have a match between whoever belongs to this department and the workspace that they can belong to or they can utilize. Of course, you can have one unit having multiple locations where they're working, but one person would definitely work on only one location. You can have multiple at a point in time. You can have one person working in multiple locations, except you're a doctor. Okay, great. So that's done. And so the next thing, again, is to then give roles to the department. Okay, really, I think we can step that up. Okay, so roles to the department. So he goes back into the system, and he basically roles to the department. So you choose the department, you choose the model. Okay, so let me do things logically. So I can choose radiology department. Okay, got it. She's already got radiology, so I choose radiology and I choose all those and I assign that to them. So everybody in radiology has got, this is accessible to everybody in radiology, but at lower level we then choose one person and can give him a report and choose another person, or choose a unit and give them a report, or choose person and you can mix them and match them. So basically you come to role to department and you do that as well. Okay, so once that is done, the ball is then passed back to the departmental administrator to begin to add employees to unit. I mean, really, they can do this as a parallel. It doesn't necessarily follow that one person must wait for the other to do that, really. Once you set up unit, you know, that's done. The key point is just for the departmental administrator to be the person that's creating the unit. And then passing that information across, you know, to the global administrator. So the next thing to do after the role has been done is to put employee to unit. So employee unit mapping. All right. So you choose the employer, you choose from the pool, and then you choose the unit, and then you match, and you save. Okay. Then after that is the crude, is the employee crude, where you then take the employee and you assign them particular employees. So you have employee crude. So there's nobody in this, but really you'd have a pool, you pick up the employee, you can pick a batch of employees and assign them. So you pick up the unit, you list the employees in that unit, you pick up the people there, and then you assign them a role that you want them to take. That's done. I tried as much as possible not to go in depth, but just talk about it, because I think the first thing is for you to get an overview and understanding of how the system is organized. And you probably watch this once or twice, get especially this latter part where the process of installation I'm discussing, and get a hang of it, and then you can go back and implement the solution. So the last thing that you need to do is to then set up the roster for the patient. Of course, before this, you would have set up the shift itself. So let's go set up roster. So you need to do like shift setup. You name it. You put in the timing for the various shifts, and then save, and then come back to the roster. You choose the person. You choose the various locations and the shift that they belong to, and then the time where they will use that shift, and then you set it up. Okay. So in most instances, most people would work at a particular shift for a couple of days, maybe 2 or 3 days, and then another shift 2 or 3 days, and goes on. So you just create a setup like that. Otherwise, you can just create a general 24-hour shift and put everybody in that, even though that's not safe. So lastly, that is how you initialize the setup. And like I said, this is just to show you and give you a global view into doing this. We'll definitely be doing another video where I am going to be practicalizing this. But with this basic one, I believe that you can go into your system, you can engage with your system, and be able to initialize the system, because it's pretty simple to use when you know that when you know what is required from it. So thank you very much. It's nice having to see you soon. Bye.